Okay, talking now. So you've done your homework, turn it in.
Mr. Stewart, you put that on the wrong line.
So you've done your homework, you turn in your homework, and what are we about to do right now? Should I put it, what did I do?
Period six.
Well, I'm period six.
That's the wrong side then.
No, that wasn't the right side.
You guys are talking.
Yeah, okay, that was the point. So you've done your homework, and you've handed it in to me. And now what are we about to do? Do some review of that homework, right? We're gonna take, so what ought you be doing if you were gonna make the best use of this time?
Take some notes.
Take some notes on the homework. Okay. Then, tomorrow, what's gonna happen? This? You're gonna get it back, right? You're gonna get that homework back. Then you're gonna compare it to your notes and say, oh, okay, I see. We did number, what's one we're gonna do today?
13.
13, right? I had a question about 13. And then I took notes about 13, and now I can see what I did wrong, what I needed to do right on 13. Okay. Oh, and then as I compare it to number 14, 14's a little bit similar to 13. I could use what I learned on 13 to do 14. Okay. Then after the notes, after we go over the homework, what are we gonna do then? A homework review. Then you're gonna give it to me. And then we're going to move on. And we're going to do what right after that? We're going to take notes on the homework review. And this, people will do exactly these problems in the notes, right? You're going to write it down. At the very least, you can write exactly what I read on the board, and it would be better than writing nothing. Then you're going to get this back the next day, and you're going to compare. Right? It would be just as good as if I took this and wrote down exactly how you're supposed to do the problem right in your homework review. But instead, you've written that down, right? And we've talked this in class, and I see like, oh, I didn't realize that so-and-so was struggling with that question, so let's talk about that up here. I think this is really important, but this is even more important. Okay? The best thing you can do is turn around and talk to people behind you, put your pencil in between your desk and another person's desk. Yeah. That's the best thing you can do.
I can pay attention.
It's true. Okay? So, if you are taking your homework review, and then you're taking notes in that homework review, and when you get it back, you compare the two, we got a really useful tool for you to get better. I can't be the only one who takes your education seriously. You've got to get in there too, all right? So, if you're not getting it by just coming in here and sitting and watching me do it, you should be doing these things, okay? And then you need help, and when you look at those things, use those as tools to advance you along. So number 13, the homework. Point 1x. Point 1x equals 0.2 times x plus 2. What do you think?
I don't know.
What can we do first? Richard?
Distribute the 0.2.
Distribute the 0.2. All right. 0.1x equals 0.2x. What's 0.2 times 2?
0.4.
0.4. All right. Well, that's good. Distributing. That's certainly like, I may not know exactly where this problem is headed, but I can at least distribute. Right? I recognize that as a thing that I could do, and now it looks like this. And I say to myself, what can I do now, Aiden?
Subtract
0.2x from both sides. Definitely a legal move, right? Let's see what happens. What's 0.2x minus 0.2x?
Zero.
So there is no x left on this side, 0x. So on this side, all that's left is 0.4. What's 0.1x minus 0.2x?
Negative 0.1.
Yes, sir.
Well, then you took x away from the other side. Did you get it wrong?
So you did minus 0.1x?
Yeah, did you get it wrong.
Bring that up in just a second. And we'll just, we'll work it that way too, and if you do it correctly, it won't be wrong. There, that is a way you could do it. Okay. The ultimate test would be, did we come up with the same solution? Okay. So we are at negative 0.1, x equals 0.4. What would you do now? Oliver?
Oh, you divide negative
0.1 by negative 0.1. On both sides, by negative 0.1 and 4.4 by negative 0.4. 0.4 by 0.1. So negative 0.1 divided by negative 0.1, just like anything divided by itself, is 1. We have 1x now. 0.4 divided by negative 0.1?
Negative 4.
Think about it. This 0.1 here, 0.4 is 4 times bigger than 0.1, right? 4. So the numerator is 4 times bigger than the denominator. And positive divided by negative is negative, so negative 4. Sure, I can say, yeah, my calculator at the very least, and divide. Now, I just did 0.4 divided by 0.1, but in the problem, we did 0.4 divided by negative 0.1. So when I get 4 in my calculator, I know that when I write down my answer, I should do what?
Make a negative.
Right, because if this is positive divided by positive, but positive divided by negative would be a negative. So, Clint said, what about this? What if you subtract 0.1 from both sides? You can, just make sure that you do it correctly. What's 0.1x divided by 0.1x? Or sorry, subtracting 0.1x?
Zero.
So on this side we have zero. We have nothing. What's 0.2x minus 0.1x? 0.1x. 0.1x. Plus 4. Okay. Well, we don't have, what's that?
0.4.
Oh, thank you, sorry.
And then subtract.
You can subtract 0.4 from both sides. And now we have negative 0.4 equals 0.1x. And then what would you do?
Divide
by positive 0.1. And we still get negative 4. So it's still 0.4 divided by 0.1. And it's a negative divided by a positive now, so it's a negative 4. What do you think about that?
Not the same road to the answer, not the same approach.
Yeah. The mistake that I see here sometimes is like you'll subtract 0.1x, but in this next step you'll get x and equals 0.4. Like x equals 0.4. I'll make that mistake. Whatever you do, just make sure that you're paying close attention, that you do it correctly, that you're not doing it too quickly and making little mistakes. So we could do all sorts of stuff. As long as we do it to both sides, we can do all sorts of crazy things. There's lots of stuff that is not helpful. There's a few things that will move us along towards a solution. If I were to add 8 to both sides, that wouldn't really help. I would just make both sides 8 more than they were to start with. I'd get 0.1x equals, or 0.1x plus 8 equals 0.2x plus 12. That would get me much closer to the solution. Bridger?
Can we get our math book online? Because I looked on the McDougall site that you're supposed to go on and I couldn't find the book.
I was able to just Google it and somehow get the student edition.
Huh.
Or maybe, I can't remember if that was their algebra book or the 8th grade math book. I don't know. I didn't get any like access codes or anything like that with all my stuff. So I don't know. Kyle?
The social studies book only works if you're on Internet Explorer.
Yeah.
So maybe that's why.
But we were on Internet Explorer.
Hmm. Interesting.
You pay for it.
Why not?
It works on Google Chrome.
The social studies.
Okay. Let's go on to 18. All right. 18. Let's establish what this is.
Triangle.
Anything special about this triangle? Other than it looks awful?
All sides are the same.
All sides are the same. The word for that, general word for a...
equilateral.
Okay, equilateral triangle, but it's also a polygon, right? Polygons that have all the same sides are called
regular.
So it says they're all regular polygons, which means all the sides are the same as each other. So then next to this side, it says 5 minus 2x. And this says negative 4x plus 9.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What do we know about this triangle?
That all sides
equal.
Are regular.
Is this side the same as this side?
Yes.
Not your
time.
Not
time. So if this side is the same as this side, then what's 5 minus 2x the same as?
Negative 4x plus 9.
We have an equation. We have an equation to solve.
Okay.
We'd like to solve this equation. Richard?
I just have a question.
Yeah?
Does it ever matter what side you subtract or add the x or the variable from?
I'm going to say no, assuming that I know exactly what you're talking about. I would say no. I mean, you have to do it to both sides.
Right.
Right? The only thing that's going to really happen like, is if I add 2x to both sides, I'll get a negative 2x on the right side. If I add 4x to both sides, I'll get a positive 2x on the left side.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So it'll just be a difference of like which side of the x is on now and what's the sign of that.
Okay.
Like, is it positive or negative? It doesn't matter,
okay,
as long as it's all done correctly. So, Bridger, what would you say you do first? It sounds like you have an idea.
Subtract 2x from each side.
Subtract 2x, though. What's...
Sorry.
Okay, add 2x. If I subtract 2x, I'll get negative 4x on this side, and that won't get me closer to the x. It wouldn't be wrong. It'd still be a true equation. It would just be not closer to the solution. Negative 2x plus 2x is 0, so that's good. Negative 4x plus 2x is...
Negative 2x.
And we have a plus 9 there.
Mm-hmm.
Aiden?
So you would subtract 9 from both sides.
Subtract 9 from both sides, negative 4, equals negative 2x.
And then you would divide negative 2 from side.
Kyle, are you taking notes?
I got those 2 right.
Divide by what?
Negative
2. Negative 2. X equals negative 4 divided by negative 2?
Positive 2.
Positive 2, great. 18 was the last one.
The triangle.
Oh, what's that?
It's that in the bucket set 3.
Oh, find the perimeter of the regular. Okay, well, what does this tell us?
Each side is 2.
Each side is 2? What's 2?
The length of
I just circled it.
It's 2 X. Is the length
X is
of
2.
The...
X is 2. So, we have to plug it in to figure out how long the side is.
Oh.
5 minus 2x, x is 2, so 5 minus 4, that's 1. Should we plug the x in here?
No.
Why not?
Yes.
Because it'll be the same, right? All sides are the same. It's a regular polygon.
So p equals 3.
So p equals 3. Good catch. We were supposed to find the perimeter, not just the x. Always got to make sure you're answering the question.
24.
Or was there another question? About that.
I don't think so.
Okay.
24.
So there's this test tube. There's, it's been separated. Have you guys ever seen Separated Blood?
Is it a TV show?
No, I mean, like, blood that's been separated. Well, there's two parts. Well, I don't know if it's more complicated than this, but there's red blood cells and white blood cells, and white blood cells are called plasma. They're the part that fight off infection and that kind of stuff. And red blood cells, I think, kind of repair your skin. Red blood cells. The red blood cells are taking up 45% of this sample. The white blood cells, there's 5.5 milliliters of this of the white blood cells. And they're saying the whole thing is called X. The sample, the number of milliliters in the entire sample is called X. And they say a pretty obvious thing. They say that the amount of red blood cells, like the milliliters of red blood cells, is the same as the total minus the white blood cells. That's a pretty obvious thing. But they do say the amount of red blood cells is equal to the total minus the white blood cells. So the red blood cells. It doesn't tell us how many red blood cells there are, right?
Right.
That's the point of the problem. But, well, is somehow the 45% related to the total sample?
Yes.
Oliver? If we knew what the whole sample was, and knowing that this is 45% of that whole sample, could we figure out how much of the red blood cells there
yes.
were? Daniela?
Well, I'm not ready to present, but just making an educated guess, I would say that there's probably 10 milliliters in that little tube thing, because there 5 would be half, and since there's 0.5 extra plasma than there are with red blood cells, and there's 45% red blood cells, I would say that the plasma
should be a little
more
than half. Okay. That's a good guess. Oh, you think there should be 10?
Yes,
Okay, well, that's good to guess, but we want to write equations, solve equations. That's the thing we're trying to get practice in. And when we write that equation, we can be sure that our guess was correct. So let's say, they just threw a number out there, like 50. There's 50 milliliters in this sample. Sounds crazy. How would you figure out how many milliliters is red blood cells? If it's 45% of the whole sample, how would you figure out 45% of that total number? Multiply what by 50? 4.5 by 50? Divide 4.5 by 50?
Isn't it
0.45?
Yeah.
0.45. 0.45 what?
Percent.
Well, it's 45%, 0.45 as
oh.
a number. 45%, 45. Percent means per. You know what per means, right? Per hour, per percent. Cent means 100. Per 100, 45 per 100. 45 divided by 100 is 0.45. So 0.45 times any number will be 45% of that number. So 0.45 times x will be 45% of x, whatever x turns out to be. So 0.45x is the amount of red blood cells, 45% of x, is equal to the entire sample. What's the entire sample called?
X.
Minus
5.5. Oh,
no. Milliliters. Okay, so we have an equation, 0.45x equals x minus 5.5. 8. Do anything we want to both sides. If it gets us closer to the answer, then we'll probably keep going that direction. What's x minus x?
0.
Yeah, that leaves a negative 5.5 on this side. What's 0.45x minus 1x?
Negative 0.45x.
Okay, negative 0.55x equals negative 5.5.
Divided by
0.55.
Mm-hmm. Negative
0.55. Negative 5.5 divided by 0.55?
When you add 5.5?
We're not adding 5.5, we're dividing by negative 0.55.
Oh, I thought it.
That is confusing because they're very, very close to each other. But we're dividing to cancel out this negative 0.55 to be multiplied by x, right? To get a 1x. And negative 5.5 divided by negative 0.55 is positive 10. So this guess was good. It was right on.
What if we only knew, like, if it was 10 ml before that? Like, because if we, I subtracted 0.5 from the top, then put it to make it 50, and then just add it to that.
You subtract the 0.5 to make it 50?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what you mean by that. You subtract the 0.5 from the red blood cells?
Yeah.
Let's subtract 0.5, that'll be 5 milliliters.
Never mind.
And, oh, that was G that we were going to do? Just like all the other problems, perimeter is equal to area. So let's look at the equations for perimeter and area. And then we know that we can set them equal to each other, just like we've done so many times before. So which one should we do first?
Area.
What's the area of this little guy here?
1x.
1x. What's the area of this one?
1x.
1x. Is it the same?
It just says x.
It's the same. It's just straight across. Then what's the area of this guy?
9x.
3x times 3, or 9x. 3 times 3x. So we have 3x for the area, plus x, plus x. 3x plus x plus x. Or sorry, 9x, not 3x. Thank you, Clay. 11x. We add them all together, we get 11x. So area is 11x. Let's look at the perimeter. Perimeter is all the way around. Aiden? So we got
2 plus 2 plus x plus x.
So 2, that's this one, and this one, and this one, and this one. 2 plus 2 plus x plus x. Plus x plus x?
2 more x.
Why 2 more x's?
Because it's the top
of the top of this?
Yeah.
If I walked around the shape, I would not walk past this. I would walk around the outside like this. Right? So I wouldn't count that x. But what about this? It doesn't seem like we counted this. How long is that?
X.
1x.
How do you know it's 1x?
Because
there's
2x's,
and then there's
3x's. 3x's, 2x's here, 1x left over. Okay, so plus x plus x plus another x. All right? So we did 2 plus 2, x plus x plus what?
3x.
Plus 3x, because that top side.
Plus 3.
Plus 3.
Plus 2.
Plus another 3. So we added this plus this plus this plus this, added these 3x's here, added that 3x there, added this 3, and added this 3. So the perimeter is equal to 2 plus 2 plus 3 plus 3. So 10? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10? 3x plus 3x is 6x. What do we know about this? This figure? A equals P. And here is A, and here is P, and so 11x equals nx. No, 10 plus 6x. So I'll do beta. How would you solve this equation?
Subtract
6x
from this x.
Subtract 6x, there's nothing there anymore. And now we have 5x equals 10. Right? We get to this step, we've seen equations like this so many times. A number times x equals a number, and we almost, with muscle memory, divide both sides by whatever is multiplied by x. Divide by 5 on both sides, and x is 2. Okay. Is that the answer to the question? The question is?
The question is, what's the
area? The question is, what's the area, and the question also is, what's the perimeter? Okay. But we have handy little formulas. The area is 11 times x, right?
Mm-hmm.
So 11 times 2, area
22.
11 times 2 equals 22. Should I plug it into this formula?
Yeah.
For perimeter.
No.
Yes.
The number is the same, right? That's the whole premise. So area is 22 squares, and perimeter is 22. Does it give us units? Doesn't, I guess we could say 22
units.
Linear units. If you didn't write that, I don't care. Yes. They did not state they were feet. The original exercise did. We got 22 squares and 22 units.
Great.
Where are we at with time today?
About 11.
11? So we're about to get out in 15 seconds? Okay, let's back up.